First up, well, a third case of the deadly coronavirus has been confirmed in the state of Kerala here in India. The patient has a travel history from Wuhan in China and is being kept in an isolation ward at a hospital. This comes after the second case was confirmed just yesterday. Remember, India's first coronavirus case was also confirmed in Kerala. A Wuhan University student who had returned home had tested positive for the virus. This comes as a second Air India flight carrying 323 Indians from Wuhan landed in Delhi. The plane also carried 7 people from Maldives. This was the second phase of the evacuation drive carried out by India in the coronavirus hit Wuhan. Earlier, 324 Indians were evacuated, taking the total number of evacuees to 647. The passengers were screened by a joint team of the Airport Health Authority and Armed Forces Medical Services. The health officials said that the passengers were doing fine. However, not all Indians were allowed to board the plane. 6 Indians were offloaded in Wuhan as they had high temperature. Now, all the Indians who have returned from Wuhan, which is the epicenter of the virus, have been quarantined in the Indo-Tibetan border police facility near Delhi and the defense facility in Manesar. The evacuees will be kept in isolation wards for at least 14 days. They will undergo daily medical examination. They will also be allowed to go home if they show no symptoms after the mandatory quarantine period. However, they will continue to be under surveillance and their medical records will be forwarded to the concerned authorities for a follow-up. And well, our principal diplomatic correspondent, Nan Sibyl, has sent us this ground report from one of the quarantine camps set up by the Indo-Tibetan border police in the Chawla camp, which houses Indians evacuated from Wuhan. Let's go across to him. And Siddhant also gave us the details about the particular camp and the precautions being taken.
I'm standing near the ITBP's Chawla camp facility, which is hosting approximately 404 people who have been evacuated by India from Wuhan, the epicenter of the coronavirus outbreak. It includes 7 Maldivians and 1 Bangladeshi citizens who have been evacuated from Wuhan. But if we talk about the facility, outside the facility, also a lot of precautions being taken. Inside, of course, we know the necessary precautions being taken. People, of course, as of now, we know the reports coming that they are hale and hearty. And of course, all tests have confirmed negative that there is no symptom of this disease, the coronavirus presence in them. But we know that outside on the ground, there are people who are wearing masks, including outside this camp, people are wearing masks as a precautionary measure. We know that New Delhi has been taking a lot of measures since last week, since this outbreak became a global concern. At India's airports, people are being screened if they are coming from a flight which is directly or indirectly connected from China. India, of course, has cancelled and, of course, will not be giving any e-visas to any Chinese citizens. These are part of the updated travel advisory. And also, when it comes to physical application, these, of course, also stand cancelled. But if we know that how big is this concern, India, of course, has confirmed that there is presence of 3 people who have confirmed where there is confirmation that there is the presence of the coronavirus in the southern Indian state of Kerala. So by and large, it's a global concern now. China has confirmed that more than 300 of its citizens have died because of this virus. So clearly, it seems now a global coordinated measure might be taken very soon. But as of now, nationally, governments, at least in South Asia, are taking a lot of measures, including evacuating its citizens, whether it's India, whether it's Maldives, Sri Lanka, Nepal, or Bangladesh. They have or in the process of evacuating their citizens. The notable exception, of course, remains Pakistan, which has said that in solidarity with China, they will not be evacuating their citizens. With video journalist Sanjeev, Siddhant Sibyl for WION at Chawla camp in Delhi.